By inventing new technologies day after day for bettering humanity's survival, aren't we stopping natural selection slash Darwinism from happening on the human species? And doesn't that lead to the accumulation of poor genes given enough time?
Have you seen the, like, milk crate challenge? I think that natural selection is still happening. No, I'm just kidding. I mean, it is definitely different. The system is changing, most definitely. I think that the definition of what a poor gene is changing.
And honestly, I mean, it was never really, like, there's never really a such thing as a universally poor gene.
Correct.
Right? Except for one that kills you.
I mean, right. It's always just based on your environment, your fitness. Oh, man.
Here we go.
Oh, here we go.
I think that the short version is a gene that might be poor for the current environment could easily be great for an environment in the future, or might have been a good gene for an environment, you know, 100 million years ago. You know, there are certainly adaptations that we have that are no longer useful mm-hmm. and are causing problems. But saying that a gene is a poor gene is kind of a oversimplification of the process.
Yeah, poor genes are not a thing. It's just not a thing. You have genes, and that's it. And
right.
your genes either allow you to survive and reproduce, or they don't.
Right. They're either successful or they're not successful.
And so if you have survived long enough to reproduce, congratulations, your genes are sufficient.
Yeah.
Yes? And that's all that matters. Are your genes sufficient to allow you to reproduce?
Right. And our ability to create technologies and create tools that better our situation is a very successful adaptation.
Mm-hmm.
It has allowed us to survive and essentially take over the world. That isn't really something that's like independent, right? That is a representation of, you know, the whole survival of the fittest Darwinism thing.
You're going to use that phrase. We're going to go with survival of the fittest.
She hates this expression.
It's not right. It's not good.
it gives a really bad impression when you use it, because people don't understand what the word fit means to a biologist.
Well, and there is no such thing as the fittest, which is what we're talking about right now. The fittest does not exist. The most, you know, just sufficient. Survival of the sufficient is what it is.
Right. Right. There isn't like this peak existence that biology is moving toward.
Right.
We're just kind of like haphazardly going around, and like sometimes this is successful and sometimes it's not, and then some things die off and some things survive. And
if things exist right now, their ancestors were sufficient.
Yes.
Can I say something controversial?
Maybe.
Pandas.
Oh no.
Pandas. Like, they exist right now because we have forced them to continue existing. Realistically, they're not fit. They eat like one thing. There's nothing about that that says this one's around for the long term.
Right. The real reason we keep pandas around is because
they're cute.
Yeah, they're cute. And so that brings in a lot of donations toward maintaining, conservation and maintaining our environment and stuff. And so we can take some of that money. We use some of it on the pandas to keep them alive, you know, to keep them from going extinct. But then we use the rest of it to save species that other people wouldn't be excited to save, mm-hmm. like insects.
Insects are very important, but not very cute.
Way more important than pandas.
Amphibians are having a huge extinction event right now. They're just dying off by the droves. Nobody actually cares about the frogs, but
they should.
They should. I mean, bats are an excellent example of things that are so important for insect control, something that literally actually affects your day-to-day life, but they're all dying off. They're very important, but nobody cares about them. We do need the pandas to save all of the rest of them.
Right. They motivate people to be invested in this sort of thing.
Mm-hmm. That being said, gene changes due to natural selection are not occurring fast enough for the majority of the species that currently live on the planet to survive the climate change that is occurring, which is why we gotta get this shit under control.
While climate change does happen over time naturally, it happens slowly.
Right.
Slow enough for species to adapt due to their random mutations and stuff. But it's happening so fast right now, so fast because of us, that it's just killing whole swaths of species off.
And so then the question is, what did those species do to allow their environment to survive And how are we using their environment to maintain our standard of living? Because all of these things are connected. And so it's not like you need to save the pandas for the panda's sake. We need to save the planet. Planet's going to survive. But the question is,
life will survive.
Right. Is our human life and also our way of life, is that going to survive if we've killed off all of the plants and animals that we rely on to allow us to live this way?
We depend on very specific groups of organisms to maintain our way of life.
Right.
And if those die, we're going to have a rough time.
Also, to kind of swing back around to the original question, can we produce enough technology to allow the genes that we currently have to also survive?
And I mean, another interpretation of that, right, is what I was saying was that our ability to make tools and our intelligence to design technology has made our species very successful over the last tens or hundreds of thousands of years. But at the moment, it's starting to cause problems.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, it has been causing problems for a little while.
It is causing problems.
Right. It is causing problems. And so it's becoming something that is not successful. If we let it continue to be that way,
natural selection will take its course.
Yes. And so I think my super main ultimate point here is that we are a function of natural selection. We have this biased look on it because we feel like we're separate from the process of life, and we are not.
Right.
We are not separate.
Mm-hmm.
We exist today because of natural selection, not in spite of it. And if we end up in a situation where our traits are not successful anymore, we're not going to survive it. On that wonderful positive note, I think we'll call it quits there for now.
Whoa.